dependable, steady, boring. Just gotta come home from work every day at the same time and expect you to be at the door to greet him. Expect his dinner on the table, waiting. Monday, meatloaf. Tuesday, turkey. Wednesday, wiener schnitzel. Fattening, but it is his favorite. Dependable, steady, predictable, depressing. He'll turn to alcohol or Prozac or maybe, if you're lucky, a chauffeur. Why settle for boring? Go for what you really want. Excitement. Stimulation. Spontaneity. Boredom kills. Boredom kills. Boredom kills.
It's a nightmare. Kill. You really here?
In the flesh. And the answer to all your problems.
Whichever way you got in, leave by the same route.
Not until I impart some very necessary information.
Now, nothing you have is necessary to me.
Oh, woman, how we do deny. Anyway, about this deportation thing, I know how you can beat it. Okay, as a staff member at WRCW, I can make things very sticky for the people in immigration.
Okay, stop right there. The problem is fixed. Don't try and unfix it.
No, wait, you don't understand.
No, you don't understand. The problem is solved. I am marrying Scott, and I don't need you or your media connections or any connections you have.
Why are you buying into this Chandler thing? You don't want to marry Scott any more than I do.
You are wrong there.
You want to marry him?
Yes, I do.
Why? Why? You're rich? You're the creme de la creme of society? I mean, hooking this little Boy Scout would be stepping down.
I love him.
Bull, you want your green card.
Okay. So what do you have to offer? A night or two of hot sex and then you forget my name? I know your type, Ryan Lavery.
You don't know me at all.
Oh, yes, I do. I've known so many other men like you. You give me the rush, you promise the moon, you hustle me into bed, and then you boast about it. I bedded a princess, and then you dump me. I've known more men like that than I can count.
You may have experienced countless men who look like me, or sound like me, but not one of them was anything like me. You don't know me at all.
Vasili just called. The rugs that I ordered for the excuse me, Mars, you're in a sweet position.
No, wait, you don't have to go.
Oh, yes, I do, the rugs. Gillian, darling, could I have your credit card?
Oh, Grandmama, you can't use my cards, remember?
Oh, yes, that's right. I so hate remembering
them. Oh, the rugs, Grandmama?
Please, Duchess, why don't you stay? We've got lots to discuss.
We do.
No, we don't. Pay no attention to him, Grandmama. He's crazy.
Well, that might be difficult.
What do you, think of Jillian's pending deportation?
Her deportation? Oh, my darling... You're not going to be deported, you know?
No, Grandmama, nobody's being deported. He's crazy, remember I told you? There's a little problem, but it's been taken care of, so no need to worry.
You are certain?
Yes.
Sure. Why worry? All she's got to do is marry Scott Chandler. And then she can stay here in the good old U.S. of A. forever.
Scott?
You idiot. You just ruined the wonderful surprise I planned for my grandmother.
Oh, that's incredible. It is. Instead of running home and shouting the good news from the rooftops, you kept Mom. Now, could it possibly be that you're ashamed of your bound-to-fail attempt to circumvent the folks down at the immigration office?
How dare you? You louse.
What a fetching one.
Get out! Get out right now!
I don't think so. I'm way too curious to hear what your grandmama has to say about your wedding plans.
I'd also like to know what the Duchess was saying earlier before you cut her off, that business about not using the credit cards, because what was that all about?
You push the limits, Ryan Lavery.
It's the only way to live.
And there's no excuse for rudeness. Now get off my bed.
Not until you answer my questions.
You have no business asking them. If only Gregor was here.
Gregor, yes, a valued employee. Gold medal in the shot put.
All right. For your information, nobody uses my credit cards, and nobody pries into my relationship with my grandmother, let alone grill her about her opinions on my life.
You said it yourself, she's armor-plated.
There's no other way to live. Now, which part of stay out of my life do you not understand?
Well, I did my best. Let it be on your head. Just don't come crawling back to me when you're looking up from that long black tunnel wondering what happened to your life or wishing you had one. I'm due back at work, Duchess.
Well, if I were a few years younger, you might have to fight me for that one.
He's yours. I'm marrying Scott.
No, you're not.
What?
No, you're not. As the head of the Andrassy family, I absolutely forbid you to marry Scott Chandler.
You forbid me? Well, I forbid you to forbid me.
You would marry this man against my wishes.
Grandmama, you know I love you dearly, but Scott's a grown man and I'm a grown woman. We passed the age of legal consent.
Yes, but you're making a dreadful mistake.
I know what I'm doing.
You know, usually your impulsive behavior is endearing, but, well, this is insufferable and I will not stand by and let you throw your happiness away.
So who would you rather I marry? That Ryan Lavery?
Oh, my dear, I'm not suggesting that you marry anyone, although, well, you two do sort of evoke a certain chemistry.
I am marrying Scott.
No, you are not. And as head of the Andrassy family, I absolutely demand that you uphold your family honor.
But that's exactly what I'm doing.
No. No, not like this. Oh, my darling, haven't I been any example to you whatsoever?
Of course.
But then you listen to me. Because I am speaking for generations of Andrassy women. Women who could have married for all kinds of advantages. But they stayed true to their hearts, and that's why our lives are, well, they are the stuff of legendary romances. You're going to throw away this legacy to marry a man you don't even love?
Grandmama, you don't understand.
Oh, I do understand. I understand that you don't love Scott Chandler.
You're right, Duchess. Julian and I don't love each other.
Oh, Scott, I'm so sorry. How much did you hear?
Enough.
I do love you, I do, but I'm not gonna push you. I'll give you all the time you want.
It's not enough, Jillian. It's not. Certainly not the love of legendary romances. Your grandmother realizes that. I think you should too.
What are you trying to say?
Nothing we don't already know.
Scott, we don't have to go there now.
You're right. We can't talk about our so-called love, so let's talk about our so-called marriage.
Oh, no, Scott. You can't call it off. You simply cannot do that.
Man, I'm not calling off anything. I just don't want to pretend. Duchess, I don't have undying love for Gillian, but I'm still going to do the right thing.
Oh, my darling, are you going to have a baby?
No, no, Grandmama, I told you the truth. Well, partly. I'm not gonna have a baby, but I am gonna be deported.
Oh. Oh, then this marriage is strategic to keep Gillian here in this country.
Not the optimum reason to get married.
There's no reason at all. We're talking about a marriage, not a political asylum. There is a difference.
Yes, ma'am. Like I said, I realize this.
Yes, but what about romance, love, passion?
can't always get what you want.
Well, isn't there another solution, another possibility?
No, Grandmama, there is not. Scott's my only hope.
This is the best solution, considering...
Considering what?
Considering I'm partially responsible. Okay, someone I thought I knew and trusted set this all in motion because I was seeing Gillian.
Ah, a young lady.
She used the term loosely.
Yes.
And she was passionately opposed to your relationship?
Yeah, but I won't let Gillian suffer because of that.
That's very admirable. But marriage goes far more than a gallant gesture.
I know. Now, I just come from immigration. We have to be married at least a year, okay? During which time we have to prove we're cohabiting.
Cohabiting?
Okay.
And we can be called in at any time and then asked all sorts of personal, intimate questions, like what side of the bed do I sleep on? What kind of cereal do you like? Stuff like that.
Right, that's not a problem.
Okay, basically we have to study up on each other.
Study up on each other? You hardly know the color of each other's eyes.
Grandma, please, God has got the most beautiful green eyes. And we can work on the rest of the details after we're married. It's gonna be fine, right?
Mm-hmm. Now, my father invited us for tea today, remember? Are you still up for it?
Moe, I must just go and change clothes.
Okay, I'll wait downstairs. Duchess, nice to see you again.
Don't worry, Grandmama. It's gonna be fine. You must agree, Scott's a man of honor. You see, passion is not everything.
Here to gloat?
Scott, I want to help.
You've helped me enough.
But this time I really can.
You call that a file? This is a file.
Thanks, baby. You're useless.
I can't even get my fantasies right.
Oh, I forgot the scones in the car. I'll be right back.
Well, here, come in and make yourself at home.
Thank you. Oh, I love this cottage. I always thought it was so cozy and quaint.
You've been here before?
Yeah. Oh, Scott never mentioned my visits?
Oh, maybe.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Oh, wow.
I love this design.
You love that too, huh?
Yeah, so whimsical.
I'm not very good at small talk. Could I say something?
Oh, please, sure, say anything you want.
You use the word love a lot. Does it bother you that my son doesn't love you?
No, not really. Scott and I are very open about our feelings.
So, knowing that he doesn't love you, you still want to get married?
Yes.
Because of your immigration troubles?
Yes.
Well, I'm really sorry you're having a hard time, but I don't think it's right to get married when you don't love each other.
Oh, I agree with you, Mr. Chandler.
You do?
Oh, absolutely. And so does Grandmama. But you don't have to worry. Our marriage won't be completely loveless because, you see, I love Scott enough for the both of us. Huh. What's the matter?
Oh, you're very sparkly.
Oh. Yeah, I just wear them for special occasions.
Anyway, they're very nice.
Thank you.
You said that you do love my son.
Oh, yeah. Completely and totally. I mean, My love for Scott shines as bright as these diamonds. It's as real and as everlasting. You know, I was just talking with my grandmother today, and we were talking about how powerful love is and that it's so important. It's the most important thing. It's more important than money or titles, positions. Did Scott mention to you that I was a princess?
Oh yes, yes. Should I bow or something?
No. I'm really not caught up in all that. It doesn't matter to me. I mean, it does, a little, but it's not more important than my love for Scott. Huh. See, I come from a very long line of women who follow their hearts. And that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm following my heart, and that's why I'm going to marry Scott. And I'm going to give Scott the world.
How about children?
Yeah. Maybe, if that's what he wants. So, you see, some people might think ours is just a marriage of convenience, but to me, it's a marriage of a lifetime.
Oh. Oops. Sorry.
Oh, no. Now, of course, these aren't real. The real ones are in the vault. We only get to wear them to affairs of state and such. You know, those British insurance companies, they won't let us wear the real ones. We only allowed to wear the paste copies for everyday use and so on because, you know, these are priceless. They one of a kind. Do you think the tea's steeped enough?
You know, I don't really care a lot about diamonds, fake or not. But I know you can't fake love. Just like you can't make somebody else love you.
Oh, darling. Here, let me. I took you so long. Come in. Have a seat. You smell lovely. See, Mr. Chandler, I plan to spoil Scott rotten. Here, help yourself. So, Mr. Chandler, how do you take your tea? Like Scott? Very sweet.
Hi, Ryan Lavery in sales. Say, how would you like to be the new producer of Enchantment Cosmetics media advertisements? I'm serious, man. All right. Yeah, I'm in Liza's office right now. I'll be down in a couple of minutes to discuss the particulars. All right, what's in it for me? It's my deal. Just seized an opportunity that makes everybody happy. That's all. All right, I'll be right there. Here is to a win-win situation. Who needs women? Hey, princess, to what do I owe this dubious honor?
Listen, you serpent. No more slithering around, circling me like prey. You stay out of my bedroom and out of my home.
No need to shout. I can hear you just fine.
You keep away from me, and you keep away from my grandmama.
Hey, who's zooming who? You just barged in here searching me out.
Only because I had a message to deliver. Personally. Any ridiculous notions you have about us is just ridiculous. I'm marrying Scott.
Well said. And don't bother sending me an invitation. I'm not into farce.
Not on the guest list.
Good. I got better things to do with my time.